Hello, and welcome to Todd Plays The Sims 4 Nerd House. It is the morning after the big wedding, and the nerds are all getting some breakfast and getting ready to start a new day. Here we go. The newlywed husband and wife are sitting next to each other. You're like, hey guys, how are you doing? Did anybody do anything fun yesterday? Because I got married yesterday. Did you guys do anything interesting? And Joey's using his alien psychic powers to analyze Spencer. Joey, I don't actually think people like it when you psychically get into their heads like that, but... Oh, well. I expect on the planet Joey is from, that sort of thing is perfectly normal. Where's Kat? Oh! Why is Kat sitting all by herself in the living room? Huh. Oh, well. I guess, you know, she's big enough, old enough to make her own decisions. If she wants to sit over there, she can. Maybe she's like, I don't know, sometimes kids get rebellious. And they're like, I don't want to do what everyone else is doing. And the only reason why is because everyone else is doing it. And it's like, okay, kid. Go do your thing. Whatever. Whatever makes you happy. And whatever would make Julie happy right now is going to the bathroom. Which she is going to do. Oh, she had to flush before she went to the bathroom. I guess the last person to use it didn't flush. Well, I love that The Sims has little details like that. You know, like that's something that happens in real life. Sometimes you want to flush beforehand because it's not quite, you know, up to code. And I love that The Sims actually takes that into consideration. Okay, well, enjoy going to the bathroom on a nice warm toilet, Julie, because it's time for the honeymoon and you guys are going camping. All right, Sean, let's take the family, and it's now officially family, out on a, where do I go for this? It's been a while, there we go. Wait, is it take a vacation? I think it's take a vacation. All right, we're going to go camping. One of the first expansions to this game. Oh, by default, it's just selected everybody. No, actually, we want this camping trip to be kind of a honeymoon, so we're not taking everybody. Although, I feel like Joey would really want to go on the camping trip because it's a great opportunity to collect more specimens and stuff, and he loves doing that. But, no, one of the first expansions to The Sims 4 was, I forget what it was called, but it was basically... the ability to go on a camping trip. And I think that... And that's kind of the only zone... Well, there's another zone where you have, like, shops, where you can run your own store or whatever. But that's not very vacation-y. So going on vacation to Granite Falls, it's kind of the only zone that is, like, away, that you can go and live in the zone for a while and really be... out of the rest of the big city or whatever. Because even if you go to some of the other places, I mean, you can't really live there. But here, you can live here for a few days. Let's go to the campground, the most rugged campground. We're going to pitch a tent. We're going to do it old school. They've got some really, like, ridiculously fancy cabins. And that's nice. But we want to go camping. And we're going to be out here. Let's be out here for 2 days. Yeah, let's do 2 days, and we're going to be roughing it, and this is their idea of camping. This is their idea of camping, and this is their idea of a honeymoon. I feel like they would want, like, for their honeymoon, they would want to be like, let's get out of the nerd house. Like, we love everyone else in this house, but it's crowded. Let's go as far from other people as we possibly can go. So... And that's this. I mean, this is far from other people. I really love this zone. You know, and it's funny. When I actually am playing the game, I don't come here that often. I don't come here as often as I should. Because it's just such a beautiful lovely place with the forests and the trees. Oh my goodness. Okay. The Sims is a wonderful game. Okay, so here we are. So I feel like Julie and Sean have probably gone camping at some point in their life before, and so they're like, knew what they were getting into. But Kat has never really left the nerd house, and the nerd house is filled with TVs and computers, and I expect that she would be kind of like getting some culture shock out here, like, where are we? Where are the computers? What is happening? So I feel like Sean and Julie would have to kind of come over and be like, don't worry, we're going to have fun, I promise. And she's going to be like, where are the computers? You're going to beg for a new toy. She's going to be like, please, can I have a video game or something? What is this? Where? Please, please give me a computer or something. They're like, no, don't worry, it's gonna be fun. Usually there's, here it is, yeah, usually there's a place to play horseshoes. So let's start, let's play horseshoes with everybody. I think Sean would be like, don't worry, look, we're gonna have fun, look at what you can do out here. There's fun things you can do here that you can't do in the big city. Like play horseshoes. Yeah, which actually, I mean, they have a backyard, they could play. They could put horseshoes in their backyard if they wanted to, but... Okay, are you going to play the game, or are you just going to... Maybe they were discussing the rules. They were like, this is how you play. And now he's going to... Oh! Not quite a point. grabbed a screenshot there. Or like Kat and Julie are talking while he's taking his turn. Kat would still be like, so we just throw the horseshoe at that pole? Like, I don't understand why that's fun. But okay, I will try. Are you gonna try? I feel like it's somebody else's turn now. There we go. Julie's gonna go. I love all the animations they make, like You can actually see him throwing the horseshoes, and it bounces in different ways and goes in different places. It's like, obviously they didn't develop a physics engine, but they made multiple different animations of that throw so that it could kind of look really realistic. They've really done a good job with this game. All right, Kat, you're gonna do great. She's like, what am I doing? I'm throwing this? Like that? Is that what you do? Did I win? I don't... Shouldn't there be a high score? Where is the scoreboard? How do I know who's winning? How do I know what's going on? She's like, Oh, hey, while she was taking her turn, the park ranger came by to say hello. The park ranger's got long gray hair. Like, the park ranger is... Maybe she's a retired grandmother? She's like, I'm going to work in the park. I've always loved the outdoors my whole life, and now that I've retired from my job and I have free time to do whatever I want, I'm going to volunteer down at Granite Falls and be a park ranger and out in nature all the time, because that's what I love to do. Oh, and Sean's like, I did good. All right. See, and I think this is probably... like exactly what Sean and Julie would have wanted, is like time alone, just the two of them and the kiddo, family time away from the rest of the nerds. No offense to the nerds. Oh, she's kind of sad. Okay, so let's see. So we've been playing some horseshoes. Now there should be a place. We need to buy a tent and set up a tent, and there should be a place we can do that. So here's the outhouse. And so they're not going to have to go in a bush, but you know, the bugs and stuff, there's always so many bugs at the outhouse. That's fairly realistic. So yeah, it's not as nice as an indoor toilet, but it's not as bad as squatting behind a bush either. So yeah. Okay, where is the place where we can buy a tent? I think it's over here. Okay, yes, let's see. Take me to bathroom? Why? I don't need someone to walk me to the bathroom. Well, that's weird. Explore Woods. Buy supplies is what we need. I wonder what the Explore Woods option does. Okay, why don't you... Can he stop playing horseshoes without interrupting their game? Like, I want them to be able to keep playing while he goes and buys a tent. And there should be a lot of collectibles around here, too. There's a whole set of plants here. Oh, you know what? Cat needs to go to the bathroom? Yeah, she kind of does. Okay, well, maybe we should all, maybe the whole family should go in and, not into town. I almost said should go into town. Here it is. We should go to the, I don't know, this is just kind of the center. I guess that's the mascot for this park. We should all go into the city, well, not the city center, the park center or something. I don't know. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of plants you can get here that are not anywhere else in the game. They're only in the zone. And you can use them to make herbal remedies and stuff. So, okay. Yeah, herbalism. Which is a fun thing to do in World of Warcraft as well. Okay, well, let's start with a tent. We're going to need a tent. Get the nice green one, I suppose. Let's... We're going to need at least two tents, I suppose. And we need a cooler. We'll get the green cooler to match the green tent. Let's see, are these inflatable beds? Yeah, inflatable beds. If we have a tent, I don't think we need a bed. Let's see, we should have... We probably have a campfire there. But since we don't have a cabin, we need... Like, we don't have any furniture. So let's get the essential gaming table. And, might be a good idea to grab three chairs. Okay. Okay, let's start with that. Oof, that's $1,800. But we've got some money. We can do that. We can do that. Okay, let's have everybody... Hi, Meg. No, we can't hang out tonight. We're camping. We're out of town. Okay, let's get everyone going to the bathroom. We can't go camping right now. I'm sorry. Of course we can go camping right now. We can't go like to a club or whatever Emerald wanted us to do. Okay. And look at that. And that's why they wanted to go camping. They're trying to get away from all these people. It's like, even when we leave the city and we go out into the woods, we're still getting phone calls. People are still calling on their cell phone. It's ridiculous. Leave us alone, people. Okay. Let's see. Little cat came out. Actually, we could hang out here for a little bit. Are they hungry? Oh. Sean's hygiene is way low. Did you not take a shower before you left? Fortunately, we can do that there. Oh, she's going to stargaze. I wonder if everybody's hygiene needs some help. There we go. She's like, well, actually, the sky is really pretty here. There, hey! Wow, well, she's not cloud gazing, apparently, because there's no clouds. Alright, let's see, can we actually... Oh, what is that? Hide in the dumpster? I want to see what that is. Oh, there is a sink here, it's on the other side. Do you get in it? What are you doing? Oh my gosh! There is actually trash in there, cat! What are you doing? I don't even... Like, what... is happening. She is... I think she could do it because she was embarrassed. She was embarrassed. It really bugs me that the aliens get discovered. Like, Julie and Kat are not hiding anything. They're not being discovered. They're not wearing a disguise. They're obviously aliens. Okay, and oh my gosh, then they'd be like, where did Kat go? And I'm like, oh my gosh, Kat, what were you doing in there? Seriously, Kat, you should be even more embarrassed now than before. Go take a shower. Is she hidden there because she was embarrassed? But, like, I don't feel like hiding in the trash is a good way to fix your embarrassment issues, right? Like, you're still going to be embarrassed. Because that is an embarrassing thing to do. Okay, let's cook some hot dogs. And I know we're away from our campground, but we've got a nice little place here to cook and everything. So let's do that. Hug somebody. Well, we should. We should. Let's see. Julie, can you find any of these collectibles? There we go. Let's harvest this. Collect insects. There's a lot of things in here in this zone that you can't collect other places. Oh, Julie has not done any gardening until now. She's just acquired the gardening skill. Well, that's good. You can help Joey with his garden when you get back home. Well, that's an onion plant. Carrot plant. Carrot. Potato. These are all regular plants. We can get those in the regular place. But still, it's kind of cool to know that we could harvest them to, if we wanted to do any cooking or anything. Fishing. We should totes get our fishing on. Oh my gosh, this whole zone is just lovely. All right, let's look for frogs, and let's collect insects. There's a lot of people here too, just out enjoying the wilderness. Okay, Julie's gonna do some of that stuff. All right, their cat looks like she's in a good mood. Hey, let's grab a hamburger. Let's get both of you to grab a hamburger and have Julie grab one when she's done collecting her things. Yeah! And Kat's like, oh my gosh, when I was in the garbage, you know what I found? Oh my gosh, I found when people are throwing away their, I don't know, their, I don't know, their used bug spray, because there's mosquitoes there. And did you notice he actually had to swat a bug there? That was pretty cool. Why didn't you eat your hamburger, dude? Grab a hammer. I know they're not super hungry, but I mean, when you're out camping, you gotta have a barbecue grilled hamburger thingamajig. It's part of the experience, cooking over an open flame. Although this is a pretty nice barbecue pit. I mean, that's, you could have something like that in your house. And there comes Julie. You know, I should have given them outdoorsy outfits. I should have given them all camping outfits. That would have been smart. Oh, well. And you know, this isn't necessarily, like, I wanted them to do something special for a honeymoon. And this isn't necessarily what a lot of people would do for a honeymoon, going out, you know, camping like this. But and bringing the kid. Usually honeymoons are just the husband and wife, or, you know, the married couple, but I feel like they would want to bring Kat for something like this. And, I mean, some people certainly would go camping for a honeymoon. Hi, lady in the pink shirt. We're having a family outing. But by all means, join us and then make fun of us for some reason. Why are you here? Look, there is a huge forest. There are other chairs and things. There's a bear here. There, yes, go away, you weirdo. Seriously, who sits down at a family gathering? Oh, he farted. Who sits down at a family meal and just starts, like, insulting the people? Like, that is so rude. Okay, and now the bear is going to join us. It's not actually a bear. If you've never played The Sims before, it's just a person in a bear suit. You can see the zipper right there. This is actually a costume that people can put on. And I think you've probably seen people wearing the bear costume already. Oh, sure, Julie and Sean had a date when it was Bears Night. That's right, at one of the restaurants. So they were wearing bear costumes. So yeah, so you guys knew that already. Julie's cleaning up. She's like, why are strangers sitting at our table? This is weird. And this one is dressed as a bear, which is even more weird than the last weirdo who came by. Oh, Oh, she's cat is tense. It's unbearable from being nearby a bear. It's okay, cat. It's not a real bear. It's not a real bear. It is a person in a bear suit. All right, let's clean up the rest of these. I don't want them to get stinky. Julie just grabbed another one. What else can we cook, actually? What else can we grill? Fruit, hot dogs. Hot dogs are good when you're camping. Oh, cat got her social skill up more. Tofu dogs, grilled fruit. I've never had grilled fruit in a... Like, I've had grilled fruit at, like, a restaurant, but I've never grilled fruit myself or at a campground or anything. Oh, cat's gonna do some more looking up at the sky. What can I figure... Who is this bear? It's Blair Carbajal. Blair Carbajal. Hi, Blair. Nice bear costume, I guess. I feel like you're being kind of weird right now, but okay. I do like that these places in The Sims are populated, you know? Like, that there's other Sims here fishing or wearing bear costumes and stuff. It makes the whole world feel more alive. Like, there's a person out doing something. Haley Kenner. See, she's out doing things. Yeah, it makes the whole thing feel more realistic that there's other people out in the world. You see them at the park. You see them at the campground. You see them at the clubs. Can we do anything here? Oh, maybe this map just like shows you where stuff is. All right, let's get everyone back at the lodging. I think that'll bring us back to our campsite. Yeah, Julie, maybe stop talking with Blair the Bear. Blair the Bear, the Bear Blair. The Bear Blair. And these two are going to go jogging back home. Well, not home, but to the tent. Oh. Uh-huh. Yes. Harvest some strawberries. Oh, I'm still on Julie. Oh, yeah, I guess Julie's going to do the harvesting of that, too. Maybe Julie's like, maybe she told Joey, because they're both aliens, so, you know, maybe they're friends, and she told him, like, hey, I'll collect a bunch of... samples and stuff. Oh, I bet I have to be on Sean. I'll collect a bunch of samples and stuff. Since we don't really want you coming with us on our honeymoon, but I will collect all the samples and things that you would want collected. Oh, I didn't necessarily mean for you to put the tent right there. But I guess that's okay. Oh, wow. And Kat just immediately went in the tent and went to sleep. So, okay. So that's good to know. He'll put it wherever he's standing. It's kind of weird that they're facing away, but whatever, I guess. I guess it doesn't really matter. And let's go over here. And Julie. Oh, she's cloud gazing. Okay, that's cool. All right, let's place the chair. And what if I just stand in the same spot? Will they be like next to each other? These chairs are kind of arranged strangely, but oh, there we go. Oh, okay. Now I can. Now I can move them. Okay, well. I have forgotten how to rotate. Or else I'm just not able to rotate. I don't know. Why can't I rotate it? Oh, well. That's okay. And what else? We got a we got the cooler. Why don't you rotate? That's weird. Have I just completely forgotten how to rotate objects in The Sims? Maybe I have. I don't know what I'm doing. How do I play this game? Julie went to bed too. Like, it's only 8:30, guys. Okay, well, Sean's kind of tired, I guess. See, let's grab a drink of water. You know, when you're out in the woods and you're doing like physical activity and stuff. Oh, I was selected on Julie. Okay, well that's okay. They'll both grab a drink. It's important to stay hydrated when you're out in the woods and you're exercising and things like that. There. Oh, it's too bad we don't have an easel. Sean could do some painting out here. That would be good. He could paint the trees and everything. Why don't we get them to do some chatting? You know, now that the kiddo is gone to bed. Okay. Oh, well, that makes sense. I don't know. I guess maybe we didn't really need chairs because we have a perfectly good place to sit right here. I know, those mosquitoes. And they're inspired from being outside. Oh, it'd be really good if he could paint right now. Tell a funny story. Oh my gosh, can you believe Kat hid in the trash in that dumpster? She is such a weirdo. Okay. And they'll chat and kind of hang out a bit while the kid's asleep. And be like, isn't this nice? We're finally married. We're out here as a family, staring at the stars. Feel like it's a little weird that they're in such perfect unison. Like they're both looking to the right and the left and at the exact same time. Like, how are they so synchronized? Oh, nice! They actually do have stars coming out at night though. So that's cool. They can actually be stargazing. Wow. Look at that moon. Sweet. Okay. And maybe they'll do a little flirting. Oh, they're seeing like constellations. Oh, and she sees the space shuttle, apparently. Wow, that's a tongue twister. Seriously. She sees the space shuttle. That is an honest-to-goodness tongue twister, straight up. That's a twisty tongue. Why is there a send home button? None of them are going to send anyone else home. They're not going to be like, you get out of my forest, go home. That's ridiculous. Why is that button even there? Maybe they could invite, I wonder, can you invite other people to this zone? If you can send people home from it, maybe they could invite people from the Nerd House here just for a little bit and then send them home. I don't know. Yeah, let's get some, you know, they're newlyweds. And they probably want to do a little stuff under the romance category. That's what newlyweds do, after all. Let's see, where's the smoochin'? There we go. Do some smoochin'. Newlyweds love smoochin'. There we go. Smoochin' in the woods. And, profess undying love. Maybe we'll try to get a view that doesn't have the trash can. There he goes. You're like quoting poetry to her or something. Like, oh, your hair is as pink as my heart is. when it's in love with the pinkness that is your soul. I don't know. Hopefully he had something better prepared. Like, hopefully he had a better idea than that. All right. And they're going to go to bed. And I'm going to turn off the recording here. And we will come back when it is morning time. All right. It is about 6 a.m. the next day. And Kat has already gotten up. And I wonder, can we start the fire? Because obviously she is a little kid and she should not be starting a fire all by herself. But I feel like she might be a little mischievous. She's up all by herself. The parents aren't up yet. She might be like, but nope. Doesn't look like... That's probably good. The game, I don't think, will allow her to start... Will allow a little kid to start the fire, so... That is good. I wonder if she can cook anything, either. Since, yeah, it's not like a microwave. You gotta use... Yeah, she's not allowed to play with matches. So, she is hungry. She's gonna have to grab some granola out of the freezer. Or out of the ice chest. The cooler. I think that's probably safer anyway. But yeah, like, what does she do? Like, her parents are still asleep in the tent. And, like, she's been up. I mean, she's old enough to get up and do things on her own. But at home, she gets up, and doing stuff on her own means getting some food out of the refrigerator, you know, maybe putting it in the microwave, and then, like, turning on the TV or getting on the computer, things like that that she knows how to do. She's done a million times. But now she's awake, kind of all by herself in the forest. Like, she's never been here before. She's not used to this. She's like, what are these mosquitoes? What are these bugs? She's like, what do you do? Seriously, what do you do in the forest all by yourself? She's like, there's no music, there's no computer. Why did they take me here? Although she seems perfectly happy. She's dancing, kind of singing to herself. I still, like, if I was her age and I was out here in the forest for, like, the first time in my life, I would probably play a game on my phone. There's only one day left in the vacation. I know. It was only a 2-day vacation. But yeah, that's what I would do. I'd be like, whatever, I'm gonna play Tetris on my cell phone. And that will be my happy place in the middle of this strange world. Alright, let's clean up your bowl. Let's get the parents up. Come on, you sleepyheads. They're still sleepy. They are still tired. Well, the worst thing for her to do would be to wander away from the tent, but I think she just might. She might be like, I'm going to go look for frogs. I'm going to go, man, look at this beautiful scenery. This is a wonderful, wonderful place. Yeah, I think she's going to get bored. And maybe her phone is running out of power, running out of charge. So she's going to wander around looking for frogs and looking for plants and just generally not doing what her parents would want, which would be for her to stay in the campsite. She's going to go off and do some things. Just kind of wander around. You're like, oh, you know, maybe this isn't so bad. Look, I'm going to look for frogs. Oh, hey, oh, that'll be fun. Ah, babadoo. Meanwhile, okay, their energy is getting a little better. Read Wilderness Digest. Why are you going to, don't do that. Okay, why don't you go ahead and get up? And Julie, you do. They're going to get up and they're going to be like, okay. And Sean's going to be like, I'm going to start the, I'm going to make some food. I'm going to have some, why not? Hot dogs for breakfast? Why not? It's camping. You can have hot dogs for breakfast while you're camping. And Julie's going to be like, I'm going to go wake up Kat. I can't believe she's still asleep. She's going to be looking in the tent and she's going to be like, oh my gosh, Kat's not here. Kat's not in her tent. Like, where did she go? Like, I don't know where she went. She's lost in the woods. Of course, there's not really a way to, the game's not really programmed to handle this little story that I've made up, so they're actually not upset because they're not programmed to respond appropriately. Oh my gosh, Kat has learned how to fish. She's learned how to fish all by herself. Like, I just told her to look for frogs and like look at a flower or something. I didn't tell her to go fishing. She came up with that all on her own. Well, that's neat. Actually, we should get the whole family fishing, yeah, but I feel like she should come back home and get some breakfast first. Yeah, I don't know. My little story about, oh, she wandered off and they'd be so worried doesn't really work because there's no way for me to really tell the game, hey, make them be worried. Instead, they're just like, eh. I mean, if we really needed to find her, we could just click on the button. Maybe that's it. Maybe they've got, like, her phone rigged or something with the GPS. So they're like, they can keep track of her all the time. So they just bring up the phone and they're like, oh, well, I can see she's just down there by the river. She's fine. They probably called her since apparently their cell phones work out here. They got a phone call from one of their friends. So their cell phones work out here. So I guess they probably just called her and like, where are you? And she's like, I'm down by the creek. And they're like, okay, well, you're okay, right? She's like, yeah, I'm fine. I'm like, okay, well, why don't you come back? You should come back now. We're having breakfast. She's like, okay. That's actually probably true. Like, when I went camping as a kid, we didn't have cell phones. So if I wandered away, it could be, I mean, potentially, it could be pretty bad. I could get lost or something. It could be a huge deal. But nowadays, as long as you're camping someplace with cell phone coverage, and a lot of the, you know, campgrounds, like, this is obviously, they didn't just wander off into the woods. This is a campground. They've built cabins here. They've built a squirrel chipmunk statue. They have park rangers here. They have facilities. They have a place to buy supplies. They have a store, an outhouse. You know, this isn't just the middle of the wilderness. This is actually a place where somebody has invested a lot of money in making this into a spot, a tourist spot, a vacation spot, whatever. So they probably have cell coverage here, you know, realistically. They'd probably be like, hey, you know, we'd get more campers here if they could use their cell phones here. Kat, why did you, she took a hot dog and then she put it in front of Julie. Like, Julie's like, I already ate. Thanks. Okay, she's gonna have her hot dog. What are you doing? Oh, he's relaxing in the tent. Well, that's cool. Here, we got one more thing, though, that we didn't set up. We bought a table. Oh, yeah. Sean's been fishing. He's even got a fish. All right. We've got... Oh! I bet we need chairs, huh? It's a good thing I happen to have gotten chairs. Ah, they're getting smoochy again. Maybe, are these chairs not going to work? Or they're tilty. Ah! Why do I not remember how to rotate objects? Ah, this is bugging me. Okay. Cherry. Okay, hold on, guys. I gotta fix this. This is bothering me. Ah! Okay, so I figured out how to rotate the chairs, but these are the wrong chairs. These are the wrong chairs for that table. So we're gonna go back. We're gonna try to buy the right chairs. See that? This happens when you're roughing it. When you're roughing it, sometimes it takes a little while to figure things out, you know, because you're in the woods. You don't have all your normal doodads and gizmos. Why are they both going there? Oh, she wants to hug him. Like, well, that's nice, but maybe come back and hang out with the cat, maybe. Okay, let's see. Because she's like... You're leaving her alone again. You don't want her to wander off all over again, do you? Like, I wonder what happens with the air mattress. Do they just sleep on the ground then? Huh. Maybe it's one of these chairs. Are these the chairs we need to use that gaming table? Because these look too fancy to sit at the gaming table. If the other chairs don't work, I don't think those would either. Okay. Let's do that. And what do you get here? It's just food and vegetables and stuff. Huh? Okay. Let's buy these things. All right. And Sean, come back here. Okay. Now, don't play in the fire, cat. You gotten in enough trouble already. Fire is also dangerous. There we go. And Julie's here. Let's see. Sean's like, oh, we're gonna play. Or is that what we're gonna play over in the fire? I wonder what happens if he adds a log. Oh, that's neat. That's a neat little animation. And now it looks like the fire is brighter too. let's roast. Can we roast some marshmallows? There we go. Oh yeah, she can roast something too. Roast some marshmallows.
Oh, whoopee gorge.
There we go. That's neat. Sean, I think you're just roasting a stick. Like, you don't have anything on your... Oh, she dropped hers. She dropped hers in the fire. Maybe she's going to roast a veggie dog. Sean, you never even tried. Seriously, like... All you had... Oh, there! Hey, cat finished hers and ate it. That's cool. Here, let's go ahead and try roasting a marshmallow again. Sean, again, that is not... You don't have a marshmallow on your stick. Sean, what are you doing? You're just roasting a stick. That is not... Oh, there! Hey! He did get a marshmallow out of that somehow. Like, I didn't see the marshmallow, but it was there somewhere. Because he did eventually eat it. So, okay, I guess you know what you're doing, Sean. So, Julie, did you... Oh, I think he ate his marshmallow while it was still a bit warm. Okay, let's see if we can set up those chairs. Oh, that's neat. The fire is burning down to embers. Unless someone drops their marshmallow in it. Breathe that fresh air. It's so refreshing. Refreshingly fresh. All right. Oh, I know. Oops. place in the world. So what I can do is I can use the greater than, less than symbol keys on the keyboard. And I'm going to say these chairs look a little frightening. But okay. Let's see if we can play a game. Yes, now we can play cards. Oh, she's still working on her veggie dog. Okay, well, why don't you go ahead and finish your dog making your food. And they're going to play cards. And I imagine at this point, Kat's like, well, you know, we could actually play cards at home. Like, I mean, like, you know that we don't have to be outside to do what we're doing now, right? In fact, you can play Hearthstone on the computer. You can play a card game on the computer. So we could be home on our computers playing cards instead of out here with the bugs. Although she does look like she's enjoying herself. Can I see? What are their cards? Their cards have like stars on them. They're star cards, I guess. Yeah, that's all. That's all of their cards. They have these little stars on them. Huh. Well, that's neat. They apparently know the rules to the game. It kind of looked to me like all the cards were the same, so I don't know why. I don't know why she got so excited there. Ah, I got a star card. And like, oh, I just got a star card. It's like, hey, they're all the same. They're just stars. Sean, where are you going? Did he suddenly have to go to the bathroom? It certainly looks like that's where he's going. He just jumped up from the table. They were like in the middle of a game. And he's just like, I'm going to the bathroom. Bye. Runs away. Well, hi, Julie. Oh, Kat's going too. I guess everyone else decided they had to go to the potty. Come on. Maybe, Julie, why don't you go too? It seems like that's what everyone's doing now. Oh, well, and look at that. Julie needs to use the bathroom. So, yeah, everybody had to go at once. It just seemed very abrupt. And like, they didn't just wander over to the bathroom. They were running. Like, seriously, I thought Sean had seen a bear and was just abandoning his wife and child to run away from the bear. Like, I didn't know what the emergency was, but he was hauling butt. Okay, well, if this was real life, of course, they would not walk away without making sure the fire was out. Very dangerous to leave a fire going, but it's out, so they're good. Let's do some fishing! I like the fishing in this game. I don't like fishing in real life. I am not a fisherman in real life, but in the game, I really enjoy having the Sims go fishing. And I feel like Kat already was fishing all by herself. Like, she had figured out how to go fishing on her own when she was, you know, wandering off and when the parents were asleep, which was very dangerous and naughty. Bad thing to do. Good thing they had their cell phones. So, since she figured out how to go fishing on her own, I feel like she must, like, want to do that. And so while they're out here in the woods and everything, and she's like, the cards were fun, but we can play cards at home. The horseshoes were fun, and we don't have a horseshoe set at home, so that was kind of neat. And I like, but I like, you know, I feel like they'd be like, so what's your favorite thing about camping, Kat? And she'd answer, well, I really enjoyed this morning when I was wandering around exploring in the wilderness and collecting frogs and collecting plants and when I went fishing. And Sean would be like, oh, well, you know, your Uncle Joey Blixmoogle loves wandering around collecting things, too. So, you know, that's pretty cool. You and he can go explore the world and collect things. But while we're out here, maybe we should go do some more of that. You said you enjoyed the fishing, right? Let's go fishing. And she's like, yeah. Oh, that's a neat, kind of a neat image. Hey, get out of, I was about to take a picture. What are you doing? Oh my gosh. I was going to take a picture of the three of them all fishing together, lined up like that. And now, random forest ranger lady walks up and kind of spoils it. Why? Oh, I just, and now you're leaving. I just undid it. Good freaking grief, people. Okay. Okay, cats. There we go. There we go. All right. I think some of those were pretty good. I think we got some good pictures there. Oh, Sean caught a log. Okay, what is with random people walking up to interrupt family time? Like, they are surrounded by people all the time. The nerd house is super crowded. 6 adults and a child. 7 people in that house. So they ran away to the forest to try to get some quiet time alone without all these other people around. And random strangers are sitting at their picnic table, walking up and joining them in the fishing. It's like, guys, they want to be alone. Why are you, why are people constantly interrupting them? All right. Finishing up with that river. It seems like there's a lake as well. Yeah. Oh. I like the sunflowers there. That's really nice. Let's go. Did you see that house in the background? It's crazy. Okay, let's go fishing down here. Let's try fishing at a different spot. Because up there we were fishing at a like a stream or a river. Oh, Julie is level 2 in the fishing skill now. That's neat. Let's try fishing at the lake. Seriously, like, you can rent this cabin to stay in. Cabin, they call it. They call this a cabin. Look at this place. This isn't camping. This is not camping. If you are in this cabin, you are not camping. You could say, I went to the fancy, expensive cabin in the woods. You can't say, I went camping in the woods. Good gosh, this cabin is nicer than my house. Like, this is crazy. Like, this would be an upgrade, and they call it a cabin. Cabin. I went camping in a cabin when I was a kid a couple of times. You know what it was? It was 4 walls made of logs. It had 1 fireplace that no matter how much wood you put in it and how long you ran the fire, never did make the place feel any warmer than before you started the fire. And that was it. You still had to go to the bathroom in an outhouse in a hole in the ground. And the cabin was just a nice roof that would keep the rain off. Like, that's all it was. That was the only way it was superior to a tent, was that you could try to start a fire in the stove, but that didn't help much. And it was drier than a tent. Although tents they have nowadays are super dry too, so really. But I mean, that's what you call, that's a cabin. If you have multiple stories, if you've got 2 floors and indoor lighting, that's not a cabin. I don't know what this is. A house in the middle of the woods, but it's a house. It's not a cabin. People fancy camping. That's what they do here in The Sims. They do fancy camping. It's about 10 p.m. and it's getting pretty dark. Wonder if I could get, this would make another really nice picture. I'd kind of like to get, like, the moon in the shot. There we go. Okay, well, that kind of worked. All right, do any of them have photography? Sean, I feel like Sean might be a photographer since he's a painter. He might do some photography. Maybe he can take a picture on his phone at any rate. Can we just go over here, Sean? Trying to get him to stand someplace that he could take a good picture from. Man, this is all the new zone. Huh. Okay. Julie and Kat, try again so Sean can try to get a picture. Alright, no, not a selfie. Take a photo. With your camera. Okay, yeah, the cell camera is not great, but it'll work. So we've got that, but we're getting them from behind, which I guess, I mean, we can't stand in the lake, but I wish we could get off to the side a little bit at least. Something. Oh well, there's not really a better place to stand to take pictures. That's okay. We got something. Well, maybe we should just do this. Let's stop fishing. Unfortunately, you can't take like a selfie with three people, but we can take pictures with other people, with one other person. And there's Blair without her bear costume on. Hi, Blair. I dig her green hair. That's pretty cool, especially since she's in the forest and is apparently a lover of bears and bear costumes and stuff. All right, yeah, let's take there. Perfect. They're getting it. They're getting the selfie with the lake in the background, except the cameras, we can barely see the lake in the background. Oh well. And it's still good. It's still a nice background. Oh my gosh, look how bright and glowy here. I guess that's because the flash from the camera. All right, let's also get some selfies with the kiddo. Take photo with. Oh, can I not take a selfie with the kiddo? Maybe she's too short to fit in the frame or something. Yeah. I guess kids and adults can't take selfies together. Well, that's too bad. Okay, well, Sean, you could just take a photo of. Oh, they're all hugging and everything. Isn't that nice? Totes adorbs. Family hugs. Totes adorbs. There we go. Can take a picture of little cat with the rocks back there behind her. That's outdoorsy and foresty. I like to get her with the lake behind her, but I don't. Getting them to stand in the right places is going to be difficult. And it's 11:40. I think they're gonna kick us out at midnight. I haven't come to the campground in a long time. Like, this was released right. This was the first expansion, and I seriously have not been here in probably a year, real life. You know, like. So I don't really remember exactly how it works, but that's okay. Yeah, let's give her a hug. Let's give the kiddo a hug. So when do they kick us out? It might be like noon tomorrow that they kick us out. There we go, hugs. Okay, yep, yeah, they let us stay past midnight, so that's cool. Did they just take a picture together? I mean, that animation looked like they were taking a picture together. Why can't I actually take a picture together when they have an animation of them taking a picture together, but I can't actually do it? Like, that's weird. And a little annoying. Like, what? They just took a picture together. That's what I wanted them to do. All right, well, it's after midnight, and I'm happy they didn't make us go home. But it is time to go to bed, and we'll go home in the morning. All right, I'm gonna get these folks in bed, and then we will pick up the recording mañana. Okay, well, apparently we owe our bills, but we're out camping, so. And it looks like our vacation is ending in, what, 4 hours? So that's not noon. That's going to be before noon. So let's see. How are we? Actually, man. Well, we stayed up so late that we're still super sleepy. Okay. Well, let's let our energy levels come up a little bit. It'd be nice to have breakfast here at the campground before going home, but oops. Nope. I guess we didn't have time. Did not have time to cook breakfast here. They're kicking us out. Like, how does that work? Are the park rangers like coming to the tents and like, get out of here, you bums. You only paid for 2 days. You got to get out of here. Maybe they dress up in the bear costumes and they just try to scare people home. It's like, oh, we're a bear. You have to pay 111 more dollars if you want to stay here without being attacked by us bears. Roar. Anyway, we're gonna end the vacation. We paid for 2 days. Cat's gotta go back to school. Actually, that's it. The other two are unemployed. Well, they work from home. They work from home. They're not unemployed. They're self-employed, but yeah, I guess they don't necessarily have to get home right away, but Kat does. Kat has to go back to school. As it is, I think she took Monday off from school, so she had a long weekend, took a day off. That's nice, but it's time for her to get back to work, and gotta go home, back to the grind. Anyway, so that was their honeymoon. It wasn't exactly a trip to Paris or, you know, Hawaii or something, but it was nice. I think they had a nice time, and it was appropriate. Considering that they live with so many roommates, I think getting out in the woods and having some time alone is probably a good thing for them to do. Catherine is off to school. Did she leave? Oh, yeah, she's already at school. We got home just in time for her to go to school. So there you go. They had to come back so she could go to school. And let's see. Let's go up to their room and put up some of the photos. I wish there was an easier way to do this. Like to scroll through the photos and pick out the ones you want, but okay, I don't know of any other way except to like just put them all up. Oh, Sean, you got to go to the bathroom. Oh, it's okay. Oh my gosh, we were gone for a couple days and all the toilets broke. Does nobody else in this house fix the toilets? Good grief. Let's see. So this was a good one. Let's frame that one, and then we can sell all these others that are the same picture, but I take five every time because you never know when one of the pictures is going to have the pictures don't come out all the time. Sometimes they have a gnome in them or something, or blurry or whatnot, and so, okay, that's a nice one of them fishing. Yeah, actually, it's kind of okay that it's from behind, I guess, because it makes sense for the activity they're doing. Like, you would never get a picture of somebody fishing from the front, really. Well, not never, but it would be rare. And it makes sense, because this way you can see the lake and the fish poles and everything, so that makes sense. And there's a picture of little Cat, and here is a picture of little Cat as a baby that obviously was from before. They didn't take that like just now, but let's put that up and let's see. These are all the same. Oh, and see, here's some blurry ones. See, that's why there's blurries. That's why I take so many. Like, what are these? Are these, why is this thumb in front of the camera? You know, like sometimes they mess up. So you gotta take a bunch to make sure you get a good one. Although since it's a cell phone, it's a digital camera, in theory you could see immediately if it worked and just take another picture. It's not like you had to take the film to be developed and it was a week later that you found out the picture was bad. Of course, kids today won't even know what I'm talking about. Like, what? Didn't they have... Oh, that's their selfie together. Okay, so yeah, so we got some pictures from the camp, from the honeymoon camping trip, and we got some more fish. I'm putting the fish on the table. No, I wanted to. There we go. Mount it. There may not be enough room on the wall to mount just like all the fish. Oh, and we've already got one of those. That's a minnow. It's the same as the other one. I don't know. It's like he's into photography and everything, but he's also really proud of every fish he catches. He's like, I'm going to mount these fish. I'm sure Julie's like, you're not hanging those dead fish, those dead earth animals in my bedroom. And he's like, but it's our bedroom. She's like, well, you're not hanging them in our bedroom. He's like, I love your paintings and your photos. Those are great. Hang them in the wall all over the place. But why do you have to put the dead animals there? He's like, but I caught these fish. I'm so proud of myself. Isn't it so cool? I'm a fisherman. She's like, oh, brother, what are you doing? Anyway, this has been a long episode because I wanted to do the whole honeymoon in one go, and it was a couple days. So thank you for watching, everybody. We're going to wrap things up right here. And I am going to... there we go. So yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Oh, Spencer's taking the trash out. Good job, Spencer. I swear, I made him lazy, and I make fun of him for being lazy, but he's not lazy. He's taking the trash out and stuff. He's a good guy. Anyway, so yep, thanks for watching. Tune in again next time when I do more stuff. Thank you, and good night.